Welcome to Infobooth 19 channel. Today we are going to see balcony garden series video. So our next video is on gongra leaves, how to grow gongra leaves in a small pot or a container in a less space. So it is very easy to grow. So the seeds we are going to buy from shop and we are going to use it here. And from there it's just a one-time planting, and I will show you how to harvest gongra leaves continuously throughout the year from one single plant. This gongra leaves or sorrel leaves, it has lot of health benefits. It is highly rich in folate content and it has vitamin C and iron content and lot more health benefits. It has some lemony tangy flavor, so it goes well with various kind of dishes. Example, this gongra dal or chicken or mutton, so many varieties of dishes, even salad we can make with this gongra leaves. To start with, first thing always, as I say, selection of pot and selection of soil. I have taken a grow bag, and at least minimum 1 to 2 inches deep should be there for growing gongra leaves, because the gongra leaves, it grows very taller. At least it needs 6 inch to 10 inch it will grow, so it needs space to root it up. And you can use any garden soil, and you can even mix the compost which we have prepared at home itself. How to prepare compost easily at home, I have given the video already in my channel and the link is given in the description box below. It's a very simple process. So either you can grow it in a grow bag, or you can use the pot which is minimum at least 2 to 3 inches deep. So now our pot and the soil is ready. Now we will get into the seeds. I will show you how the gongra seed looks like. So this packet, I have got it for I think 15 rupees or 20 rupees. I don't remember the brand and all. So this is how the leaf looks like. If you buy gongra from shop or from the market, you can even do the cuttings. You can grow the gongra leaves from the cuttings as well. If the cuttings are very strong, we can use it directly and we can grow from there. So now whenever you're placing the seeds, just ensure that you leave some 1 to 2 centimeter gap between each seeds, because when it grows, it needs place to root up well so that healthy plant will rise up. At least 1 inch we are going to cover it using the soil. Just give a slight press so that when you're covering with soil or when you're watering, the seeds will not get disturbed or it will not move from its place. So once you cover it with soil, you can sprinkle some water. Always, as I say, till the plant germinates and till some leaves comes up, sprinkle water, do not pour water. If we pour water, we will disturb the germination and the growth will get affected. Use either sprinkler or you can take it in hand and you can sprinkle in this way. At least for the first 10 to 15 days till 2-3 leaves comes. Now placing the gongra pot. So this gongra plant, it loves sunlight. Minimum 6 to 7 hours of direct sunlight is required for growing this gongra leaves. I'm going to place it in the direct sunlight, and watering gongra plant is very, very important. Always the soil should be moist, otherwise the gongra will not grow properly. We suggest that always water your plants in the morning time so that it will have enough sunlight to take care of the seed or the plant. If we don't water in the morning time, the sunlight will affect the plant and this plant or the leaves, it will start turning yellow color. Now if you see day 6, we can see small tiny little leaves that come, and it's looking very, very beautiful. Now if you see day 18, the leaves have come nicely. So I think I have placed more seeds, that's why it is like a crowd in the basket. The leaves have come and it is very, very healthy. So at this point of time, if you see, if you observe the stem, it is very, very thin. So now also, whenever you're watering, be very careful. Otherwise, what will happen? We will disturb the stem and the root. So water very carefully, sprinkle or use the sprinkler to water your plants. Now day 30, one major important thing about this gongra leaves is it will start giving some flowers as well. So whenever you are seeing any bud or flower coming up, pick it up and throw it, because otherwise it will stop the plant growth then and there itself. So remove it, and also some kind of weeds will grow. That also you just keep an eye on that and you can remove the weeds. You see day 30, some here and there some yellow color leaves you can find. That is because we have gone out for a few days and we did not water it properly. So that's the reason we can see some yellowing of the leaves. But yes, we have come back and I started taking care of the plant again. Let's see how it goes further. Day 36, the plant has come back to form and it's looking more healthy. So you can start picking up the leaves from this stage itself. So the gongra leaves, it will be very very tasty, it is very tender. So when the leaves started growing around like 10 centimeter or 8 centimeter, you can start plucking the leaves and then you can use it. So whenever you're harvesting the gongra leaves, ensure that you don't pick it up from the root. Instead, you use the scissor to cut from the top. Then only the same place the leaves will start growing again, and the continuous harvesting you can do. Here I have left some 2 or 3 buds to show you guys how the gongra flower or buds looks like. So this is how the flower looks like. So once it comes, even before the starting stage wherever I am showing you, pick it up at that point itself, because if you leave it, the plant growth will stop there. So throughout the season you can harvest. So this grow bag I have used for many months. I did not repot, I did not put the soil again or put the seed again. Just all I did was just adding the vegetable and kitchen waste and the compost which we prepared at home. So no special care taken by adding any nutrients or calcium or magnesium to this plant. This plant doesn't attract more insects, so the insect problem was not there for me. So it was more easier to grow this plant. Now if you see, close to 35 days, from 35 days itself, you can start harvesting the gongra leaves. Here I have kept till 55. Now I'm going to harvest. See how I'm harvesting. You can take a scissor and you can cut it. Do not pluck it from the root itself. You can harvest, and growing our own greens like gives the immense pleasure. Surely you all need to give it a try. Once we start doing it, we get more addictive to this, and we start growing our own veggies, which is more organic and more healthy because we are not adding any pesticides here. Now if you see how much I have got, 2 to 3 people can have in home easily. That much quantity always we get. Now if you see the pot, how much we have plugged, after some days we will see how it is growing back. Now if you see day 70, this is the same grow bag where I have harvested the gongra leaves. Within 10 days new leaves have come. So in similar way it keeps growing and you can keep harvesting. It's very interesting to grow your greens and it is very easy. Surely you all need to give it a try. If you like my video, subscribe to my YouTube channel and share with your friends and family. Be happy, stay positive and spread the positivity to everybody. Thanks for watching.